Thank you. I'd like to welcome each and every one of you here this morning. If you're visiting, we appreciate that and welcome you back at any time. Just a few announcements. Today is Holy Communion. On Wednesday, the office will be open. On Monday, September the 13th at 7 p.m., we will begin our new Bible study. And there's a paragraph there about that. And it will be here at the church. On Tuesday, September the 14th at 6:30, we will have an ad council meeting. So mark your calendar for that. There's also a list for those for new member class that if you're interested in becoming a new member, the dates and times are listed. I would say also if you have any questions about that one, please talk to Pastor Bruce. So. Are there any other announcements? If not, we'll begin our service.
Announcements, and then Sandra, if you have others, you can just fill in. This is the last week to sign up for Bible study. We'll start on the 13th at 7 o'clock. New members classes will start the 19th. I know some of you are interested in that. First one will start at the 19th at Christ Church, but it's for both churches at 12:15 after church. So the class will be about an hour. Church Council, 6:30 on the 14th. Put that on your calendar. We have new tenants in the parsonage. The Kratz family, and I believe it's Stephen Kratz. Some of you know that Reverend John Kratz is a minister at St. Paul's Church. And his son Stephen is at the, and his family are living at the parsonage. I bring this up because, well, there was a passing, a death in the family at Christ United Methodist, but I think a lot of you out here know this person, and I wanted to mention it. She was a member of Christ Church, but again, a lot of you know Jean Pinsey. Does that name ring a bell to a lot of you? No? For a long time, she was a teacher and head teacher, sort of like a principal, at Lurgan Elementary. And some of you, I don't see Betty here this morning, but I know Betty taught with her. And so Jean was 88, and she had been in a home down in York, South York, and she passed on Thursday evening. So raise your hand if you had Jean Pinsey in school. There you go. There's some hands going up there. So I thought it was part of this church family as well. So, Sandra, any other announcements you have?
We already ate one meal before you come.
Oh, come on. Okay. Well, sorry, Deb. I'm making you late. So, okay. All right. Well, let's go ahead with the morning prelude.
Yeah, we did that too.
Oh, okay. I was late. But it's Communion Sunday. But anyway, let's go with the call to worship.
Okay. Would you rise if you're ready? Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken, but endures forever.
As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people, both now and forevermore.
The scepter of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous.
For then the righteous might use their hands to do evil.
Lord, do good to those who are good, to those who are upright in heart.
But those who turn to crooked ways, the Lord will banish with the evildoers.
Peace be on Israel.
Amen.
Our invitation to God is open our eyes, and we're going to sing it through two times. Thank you for walking with each and every one of us now to block out all the confusion and happenings of life and to focus on praising and worshiping you. Open our ears that we may begin truth. But with us now, Lord, come into our midst, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is Living for Jesus.
Yeah.
chapter 22, verses 1, 2, 8, 9, and 22 and 23. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches, and favor is better than silver or gold. The rich and the poor have this in common. The Lord is the maker of them all. Whoever sows injustice will reap calamity, and the rod of anger will fail. Those who are generous are blessed, for they share their bread with the poor. Do not rob the poor because they are poor, or crush the afflicted at the gate. For the Lord pleads their cause and despoils of life those who despoil them. Our New Testament lesson is taken from James chapter 2, verses 1 through 17. My brothers and sisters, do you with your acts of favoritism really believe in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ? For if a person with gold rings and in fine clothes comes into your assembly, and if a poor person in dirty clothes also comes in, and if you take notice of one wearing fine clothes and say, have a seat here, please, while to the one who is poor you say, stand there or sit at my feet. Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters, has not God chosen the poor in the world to be rich in faith and be heirs of the kingdom that he has promised to those who love him? But if you have dishonored the poor, it is not the rich who oppress you. It is not those who drag you into court. It is not they that you blaspheme the excellent name that was invoked over you. You do well if you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you show partiality, you commit sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. For whoever keeps the whole law but fails in one point has become accountable for all of it. For the one who said, you shall not commit adultery, also said, you shall not murder. If you do not commit adultery, but if you murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. So speak and so act as those who are to be judged by the law of liberty. For judgment will be without mercy to anyone who has shown no mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat your fill, and you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Sandra. In Proverbs this morning, you start out with a great verse to teach your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, your nephews, and that is Proverbs 22:1. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches. A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches. How important that is. When people hear the name of Otterbein Church, what does that mean to this community? When people hear your last name, what does that mean? How important it is to have a good or strong and strong name. And then verse 2, the rich and the poor have this in common. The Lord God made them all. Let us all remember that daily as well. And let us remember that none of us are any better than the other. You've heard this expression. We all put our pants on
one leg at a time,
right? One leg at a time. I hope there's nobody that jumps two legs at a time. But anyway, we're Ron, I know you do. But anyway, all right. And verse 9 says that those who are generous and blessed, for they are blessed, for they share their bread with the poor. So I say to us this morning, are we being generous? Are we tithing? Are we concerned about those less fortunate than we are? Do we show it? Remember last week, the scripture was not just hearers, but doers as well. And then we move to the book of James chapter 2 in the New Testament. It talks about the problem of favoring the wealthy over the poor, giving seats of honor to the rich. And Paul mentions that. Has not God chosen the poor in the world to be rich in faith and to be heirs of the kingdom that he has promised to those who love him? He then mentions how we need to follow the golden rule. And maybe it's not the golden rule exactly, but I put it in exactly as you learned it, I think. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Or love your neighbor as yourself. We are not, should not, show partiality toward others. If you or I go into Dollar General, do we compare ourselves to others? Do we think we are better than others in the store? Or that we are not Dollar General material? I've done that. I'm telling you, I have. People, that's not the way to be. We are all the same, no better than the other. And it goes on to say that faith without works is dead. Verse 15 said, it's on your read, if a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm and eat your fill, and yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what good is that? And then Paul goes on to give a short message of faith cannot be separated from works. It's back to what we said last week, walking your talk again. Friends, it's Communion Sunday all over the place today. We are welcome at the table of our Lord, and all are welcome at the table of our Lord today. None of us have special privileges with the Father. Jesus told a story, and I think you know it, in Luke. Two men went into the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee, and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood over by himself and prayed, God, I thank you that I am not greedy, dishonest, and unfaithful in marriage like other people. And I'm really glad that I'm not like that tax collector over there. I go without eating for 2 days a week, and I give one-tenth of all I earn. The tax collector stood off at a distance and did not think he was good enough to even to look up toward heaven. He was so sorry for what he had done that he pounded his chest and prayed, God, have pity on me. I am such a sinner. And then Jesus said, when the two went home, it was the tax collector and not the Pharisee who was pleasing to God. If, this is Jesus' words in a modern translation, if you put yourself above others, you will be put down. But if you humble yourself, you will be honored. And that was from Luke. In Maya Angelou's poem, Still I Rise, it refers to the indomitable spirit of black people, using repetition and categorization of the injustices against them in the past. No matter what the oppressors had done, they will rise up. The will of the black people will be greater than the oppression of the hater. people, this is not a message about Black Lives Matter. What I'm getting at today, this is a message about love. It is a message about the love that Christ has shown to us, and we need to show unequivocally to everyone else. There are no requirements to receive that love, from God or from us. Christ just welcomes us with open arms to this table today and every day. Maya Angelou goes on to say, love recognizes no barriers. It jumps hurdles, leaps fences, penetrates walls to arrive at its destination full of hope. And friends, we need to show that love to everyone without questions. I said, I've done it. Maybe you've done it. We need to stop feeling that we have any qualities that make us better than anyone else. Going back to the Proverbs scripture, if we have that, those feelings, it hurts our name and the name of the church. And name is so important. Jesus has chosen the poor to be heirs to the kingdom, as it says in James. People, these scriptures today show us that faith without works is dead. In other words, the proof is in the pudding. Here's the question of the week. Do we love each other without exception? Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. We are all children of the Lord. Do we favor one person over another? Do we judge people? Or do we love because all are children of God? All of us have been made in the image of God. Who is welcome today at your table? We are all welcome at the table of the Lord. Amen. Let us move now to our hymn of communion and response, Break Thou the Bread of Life. Please rise. I'm not going to get into the argument of vaccination shots or not, but he'd only had one shot and was really near death's door. Now, his sister contacted us yesterday and said that he is improving, but I would ask you to add Brian Schatzer to your prayer list. You have the list in front of you there. Oh, she had Brian Schatzer on there. I see it. Okay. We prayed for Buddy Boyd's family last week. The Fensenig family. So just look over the list there. LaDonna Noggle. Okay. Help me out here.
She's a friend of mine, but yeah. She also drove bus, and she retired from bus driving and then went to administration.
For Chambersburg District, right? She was in charge of transportation.
What's that?
She's retired.
Yeah. Well, what's wrong with her? I forget.
She has breast cancer.
Breast cancer, okay. All right.
The same scenario as mine.
As Amy, right. Okay. Okay, others this morning that we need to add to our list.
It's not an illness, but we have a niece, Anita, who is now in Rwanda.
Okay.
She is teaching. She's trying to head up a like a special needs kind of course.
Okay.
She's in the second stage of that.
In Rwanda?
In Rwanda.
Okay, what's Anita's last name?
Park.
Yeah, okay. Anita Park. All right, so we added her to our list. All right, definitely she would need prayer. Okay.
And she's not there as a missionary. This is strictly...
Okay. She's a teacher. Okay, all right. Okay, others this morning for our prayer list.
I have praise.
Praise.
I had my last checkup 2 weeks ago. Got my new glasses on Friday. And I can see very, very well.
Good.
I was concerned about being able to read that far away. And I got a call last Saturday night as we was leaving my son's new home that they were taking my brother Terry over to the hospital. They sent him back. And then they called me on Sunday with a follow-up. And the nurse asked him if he had any requests from his sister. He said, yeah, I'll tell her I'm out of candy, and I've been out for 2 weeks.
Okay, all right.
But he's doing very well.
Okay. So her first praise there was with the cataract surgery. And many of you that have had cataracts and then had cataract surgery, you're seeing better than ever. And that is literally amazing. Literally amazing. So that is a praise. So, okay, other praises or prayer requests this morning? Okay, granddaughter Wilma is back to work. Okay, thank you, Pina. Thank you for your help with communion today. Yeah. Mike, if you have your hand, okay.
I have a praise. Tuesday, we went back to New York with the doctor that did the hip surgery on Zoe, and he was thrilled with her recovery. Everything went well. New x-rays were great. She's doing things with her hip. You see she's walking instead of in a wheelchair. It went so well, he scheduled her other hip to be replaced in 4 weeks. So September 30th.
That is a praise.
She's getting her right hip, and we're big believers in prayer. We want to thank everybody here. And we felt the love of prayers.
Right. And they had this surgery. I always like to mention good surgeons. Corey Carruthers is his name, and he's the surgeon in York. What's that group called?
OSS Health.
OSS
Health. You see their commercials maybe on TV, but OSS Health. So if you're needing new hips, there you go. Praise Julie. Thank you. Thank you, Mike. So we're thankful. And we pray for your upcoming, the next one. Mike, how will you keep up with her? Okay. All right. Anyone else this morning? Go ahead.
So for the end of getting cataracts the next 2 Wednesdays,
yes.
Pray for his wife.
Okay. All right.
And my cousins in North Carolina are not well. 3 boys all have COVID.
Carolina. Okay, three boys and the mom all have COVID. And we pray for Fernando's upcoming surgery. What's the date of that, Fernando?
Wednesday.
When, this Wednesday. Okay.
Next Wednesday, go
there. Right, the other eye. So two eyes, okay? Right in a row there, 1 week apart. So, okay. Anyone else?
I have a prayer request.
Go ahead.
A classmate of mine, her name is Victoria Clark, her daughter-in-law, Courtney, about a month ago went into the hospital in very critical condition. She ended up with having a blood clot in her brain, her lung, and in her heart. She is in a rehab now.
Okay.
Well, she was unconscious, and for that, they found she had to have a stroke.
Yeah.
It has affected her left side. Not thinking that she would recover, she is in a rehab center now. She just had a post this morning where she's learning to re-talk, re-think. She has to learn all her.
So her name would be Courtney Clark.
Courtney Clark.
Okay, all right. Any other? Yeah, go ahead, Rhonda.
Update on Scott Parson. He did have his brain surgery.
Right.
Tumor removed. He has to go through some radiation and then also chemo regimen.
And that's a praise story too. Just amazing. So let's pray. Dear kind Heavenly Father, we do give you lots of praise and thanks. Lord, Wednesday was a tough day for a lot of people. They found floods in their basement, in their yards, on the streets. Lord, but we thank you for sparing us. So many people in other parts of our country, we're not as fortunate. And we pray for all of those affected by Hurricane Ida. Lord, it was a tough one. And we just ask your blessing and presence to be with those people who were affected by as much as 10 inches of rain. Wind. Be with them. And Lord, for all of these people on this list that we have this morning and the ones that we've added, each individual name is important, and each individual case for healing or love or presence or care is important. And we ask you to be with these individuals. Help them all to know that we are praying for them and that they are considered part of yours and our family. Lord, as we gave our message this morning, we realize that all of us are the same. For many of us, it's just a different person with a different problem on a different day. But we are all there. Help us to love each other as you love us. So Lord, be a presence with everyone on our prayer list today. Be their counselor, be their healer, be their friend. And we will give you thanks. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Let us now bring our tithes and offerings to the Lord.
Thank you.
Our communion table is a table. The gifts of God's love and his body and blood is a table open for all. Let us move on now to the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right, good, and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us. As we proclaim the mystery of faith,
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Now, with the confidence of children of God, let us pray as he taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Once, I've said it 100 times. As he was on that cross, he was looking right at us and saying, I love you this much. This much that I'm willing to die for you. Greater love hath no man than to lay his life down for his friends. I would ask the ushers to come forward now. Ron and Phil. We're going to do it kind of like the old-fashioned way. Not with prepared cups. This is Christ's body broken for you.
Thank you.
is his blood shed for you. Some that say that communion every month is too frequent. And yet John Wesley said that we need to commune and have communion daily with Christ. What a special gift he gave us in going to the cross. The body of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ broken for you and shed for you. Take and drink.
Thank you.
is within us, the love that was given to us by God, and bring peace to this earth. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you, his mighty countenance, and give you peace. Amen.